ဒီနေ့မိုင်းတုံးပြမှုပြည်ပင်တန်းဖြစ်ခြင်းနိုင်ငံတကာစီလုံးရေးလုံးဆောင်ရေးအဖွဲ့ မြေမြုံမိုင်းအသုံးပြုမှုစောင့်ကြည့်လည်လာရေးအဖွဲ့ကထောင်၉၉၂ခုနှစ်မိုင်းအသုံးပြုမှုပြည်ပင်တန်းဖြစ်ခြင်းဆိုင်ရာသဘောတူညီအစည်းအဝေးအကောင့်ထည့်ဖို့ခြင်းနဲ့ပတ်သက်၍ဖတ်တန်းတင်ထားပါတယ်။ရင်းနှီးမြှားကြောင်းဖြစ်ပေါ်လာတဲ့အချက်အလက်များပေါ်မှာနိုင်ငံတကာအတိုင်းအဝိုင်းကတုံ့ပြန်ဆောင်ရွက်ချက်များနဲ့ပတ်သက်ပြီးတော့လည်းစောင့်ကြည့်လည်လာရပါတယ်။ 2020ကျော်ကမြေမြုံမိုင်းအသုံးပြုမှုတောင်းဆိုပိတ်တင်ဆိုင်ရာသဘောတူညီမှုစာချုပ်ကိုလက်ခံသဘောတူခြင်းသို့မဟုတ်လက်ခံကျင့်သုံးခြင်းများကိုပြုလုပ်ခဲ့ကြပါတယ်။မြန်မာနိုင်ငံကတော့စာချုပ်နှစ်ခုစလုံးမှာလက်မှတ်ရေးထိုးခြင်းအခုချိန်ထိမပြုနိုင်သေးပါဘူး။မြန်မာစောင့်ကြည့်လေ့လာရေးမှာရေမြုံမိုင်းကင်းစင်တဲ့ကမ္ဘာကြီးဖြစ်လာစေရန်ရည်မှန်းချက်အထောက်အမြောက်စီရန်အတွက်
Landmines are an explosive weapon that is laid in or near the ground. They are triggered or the explosion goes off when the victim activates them. There are now peace talks, very serious talks for peace going on in the country. Whatever agreements the parties reach will need to be secured quickly with activities to follow them. And our movement's total approach is not a military one, it is a humanitarian one.
Twenty years
ago, an international movement started to get rid of landmines around the world. For our efforts to get that convention, we were given the Nobel Prize for Peace in
1997.
And on a global scale, we can now see that the number of people killed or injured is decreasing. It's falling every year. However, Myanmar has not joined this convention as of yet. The convention requires a ban on the weapon. And a ban means that you cannot use it, you cannot possess it, you cannot produce it, you cannot trade in it.
The ban
And all mines must be cleared from the ground so that the land can go back to productive human use. Mine clearance has not yet happened in this country, but we're hopeful that it will start soon. These 47 townships are in Kai, Kaya, Kachin, Mon, Kai, Shan states, as well as Pago and Tanintary regions.
The
map that you see on the screen right now is available from UN MIMU, that's the Myanmar Information Management Unit of the United Nations here. Townships are affected. It doesn't mean the entire township has a problem.
46 townships
From interviews with refugees and other sources, which are all located in the footnotes in the bottom of the report. No one knows how many people have actually become victims of mines in this country. The government couldn't tell you how many people have been victims of landmines, even if they wanted to. In the Ministry of Health's annual report, the only thing that they count are trauma cases. That's cases that they've received in surgery wards, in the hospitals and clinics throughout the country.
Anecdotal
evidence by former soldiers who have gone through the Mingaladon Hospital suggests that there are many. None of the ethnic armed groups provide any statistics of how many of their soldiers have been killed or injured by landmines. On this chart, which tracks global landmine casualties over the last 6 months, and number two in this chart are Afghanistan and Colombia. Both Afghanistan and this comparative chart is based on our partial figure for Myanmar. So if the real figure was known in Myanmar, it could be number two. Regardless of where it ranks on the world scale, it is a crisis for the people in the landmine affected areas of this country. Likely you are by yourself and laid on the ground after your injury for an hour or many hours. If you're not in shock, you will be screaming.
Oh,
On the left-hand side, you will see the activity of the people at the time they stepped on their landmine. This relates mostly to the civilian casualties of this weapon. Most of the people who become casualties became casualties when they went to the forest. They went to the forest to hunt for food, or they went to the forest to collect food to add to their diet.
Government,
there might have been a moral and humanitarian one, but there was no legal obligation.
Now,
needless to say, the government cannot currently meet its obligations. It will need lots of help from non-governmental organizations and civil society organizations in order to meet its obligations to landmine victims and other disabled people.
The left side is a mine that is not a lethal mine, it's a maiming mine, it's made to just maim a person. One of the most significant is that the president has asked visiting delegations from European countries to help Myanmar clear its landmines. The United States government has also recently offered financial assistance for mine clearance and victim assistance within the country. And the basic structures for mine clearance are starting to be constructed at the administrative level within this country.
Administration level
But once it does, we will be ready to move.
Okay, we The
foreign minister of the country has stated that Myanmar is considering the mine ban treaty.
Last year at this time, we could not have this conference here.
He's from Venus News Channel, and he likes to know how far you discuss with the government about the clearance of the landmines.
Oh.
The international campaign to ban landmines, as was announced earlier when Kinley gave the description of our movement, is made up of more than 1,000 non-governmental organizations. That includes all of the major mine actions organizations. There are many of them: Norwegian People's Aid, the Danish Mining Group, Halo Trust. These are all groups that clear mines to the standards of the mine ban treaty. These mine clearance non-governmental organizations had a meeting in Naypyidaw last week, on Thursday and Friday, to discuss with the various ministries that would be involved in those areas. Some of you may have read about this meeting in the press. And they were discussing the administrative necessities that need to be done before clearance can take place. So the basic administrative work of permissions to work in areas, permissions to work in the country, all of these types of formalities have basically been accomplished.
She's from Newswatch Channel, so he likes to know that you have already discussed with the government official, but what about in Kachin or other ethnic minor and groups? Did you have any discussions with them? And one of the things he likes to know that you have mentioned that the weapons, the landmine use in KIA, so, but they have heard about that KIA use the weapon is very, not very extensive one, but very soft one. They just shoot with a battery. If the battery is low, that weapon is out of order or something like that. So she has heard like that. So what's the difference between what they have?
Okay, there's a number of things in that. I will try to answer all of them. Yes, of course, the non-governmental organizations contact people on both sides, but this has to be done carefully. The most important thing is for the authorities and the ethnic groups to come to their own agreement. And while non-governmental organizations encourage that process, they cannot become involved in that process. So the role of the NGOs in approaching all sides in relation to mine clearance is to explain to them what mine clearance is, the humanitarian principles behind it, how it would work on the ground, but with the full knowledge that they have to wait for the political agreement between the sides to proceed.
ဆိုရမို့တဲ့ဖွဲ့စည်းဖြစ်တဲ့သူတို့လိုဖွဲ့စည်းရတဲ့တာဝန်ကကြတော့ဒီညီညွတ်ပိုင်းနေရှင်းလေးအတွက်ဟိုဘယ်လိုရရှိရဆိုတာကိုရှင်းပြဖို့ရလူသားချင်းစာနာမှုတွေအတွက်ဘယ်လိုမျိုးလုပ်တဲ့နေဆိုတဲ့ဟာတွေကိုတည်တည်ချာချာနားလည်အောင်ရှင်းပြဖို့ဟာအရင်ဆုံးအရေးကြီးပါတယ်သူတို့နားလည်ပြီးတဲ့အခါကျရင်ဒီဆိုရတဲ့ဒီလက်နက်ကင်တိုက်ပွဲဖြစ်နေတဲ့လူတွေကြားထဲမှာအပြိမ့်မှ
minds used and their capabilities. Many of the ethnic armed groups, not just the Kachin, do make mines that require a battery to operate. Many of the ethnic groups, including the Kachins, do make some mines that require a battery to operate. No, I'm making that statement.
然后，吉星，我们那就是吉安人，蛮好保护的。像那奥斯里，我们都没看过，对吧？那然后，伫买那只卡嘛，伊在水库边都难啊，没办法嘞。There
is no quality control on the mines made by different ethnic armed groups.
然后，伫，像那恁那干部是伊啊，恁那伫那只卡嘛，伊伊对天照顾出来，对吧？上面就咱们希望。
The amount of explosive in the mines varies from mine to mine.
然后，都伫。
Some of them just go pop and don't hurt anybody.
And some of
them have enough explosive power that there's nothing left.
And